These cuddly little critters live in nearly a million homes in the U.S. alone. But that's just the tip of the hamster iceberg. With over 20 species of hamster, there could be millions more in the wild. But every single one shares an incredible feature. They overstuff their cheeks with food. From the smallest, like the dwarf, a ping pong ball-sized pocket rocket that needs enough fuel to run the equivalent of 4 marathons every day, to the King Kong of hamsters, the European, a 14-inch titan that eats everything, from plants to lizards and small birds. So what's the secret behind a hamster's super stretch cheeks? This golden hamster is one of the most popular pets in the U.S. Amazingly, this one, and every golden hamster since, can be traced back to a single wild female captured in Syria in 1930. She was bred in captivity with a captured male, and her descendants were shipped around the world, with every female since capable of producing over 60 babies. There are now about 6 million pet golden hamsters on the planet. But all that adorable behavior, like running on their treadmill or running around your house, is a throwback to their wild roots. The wild ones roam across the grasslands of Europe and the deserts of Asia. If food is scarce, they stock up when they hit the jackpot. By stuffing their cheeks, they can carry food over long distances while hiding it from hungry competitors. To find out just how much food they can fit in those cheeks, scientists invited a tame hamster to help himself to an all-you-can-eat buffet. Using X-ray photography, they revealed the hamster's secret. It has flexible pouches in its cheeks that expand and stretch 2/3 of its body length, all the way back to its hips. This incredible footage shows that the hamster's cheeks work like a stretchable grocery bag, doubling in size. And squeezing all those nuts in is made possible by special muscles that contract to push the food all the way to the bottom. These expandable cheeks can hold half a hamster's body weight. That's the equivalent of a man carrying 150 quarter pounders in each cheek. Once those cheek pouches are filled, the hamster heads to a safe spot and uses those same cheek muscles to massage the food back up. Now that's one amazing pocket pet. But in the wild, storing all these fruits and nuts over the summer and winter means the fruit has often fermented by the time they want to snack on it. It's like hamster moonshine. So to stop these keep-fit critters getting drunk, they've evolved to have livers 5 times bigger than other animals their size to process all that boozy fruit without getting tipsy. But cute as they are, if you live in California or Hawaii, you're out of luck. Pet hamsters are banned. All it takes is for 2 to escape into the wild, and with their turbocharged breeding ability, there'll be more pocket pets than California can handle. Let's face it, camels aren't going to win any beauty pageants. But these strange-looking animals couldn't be more perfectly designed for their environment. Those long eyelashes that protect against sand and dust. Thick lips for eating prickly plants. And of course, we all know what the humps for, don't we? Why do camels have humps? Camels are icons of the Arabian desert. But the world's largest population of camels is not in the Middle East, but thousands of miles away in Australia. Australians imported camels in the 19th century for transportation and heavy work in the outback. But with the advent of the internal combustion engine, these ships of the desert were soon out of a job. A few thousand were released into the wild, and with no natural predators, their numbers skyrocketed. These Aussie camels are the one hump variety called dromedary. Over in Central Asia, the Bactrian camel rocks two humps. Now, there's more than a million camels down under, the largest feral camel population in the world. To find out what a camel's hump, or humps, are for, we've come to Alice Springs in the Australian outback to meet camel farmer Marcus Williams.
By far the most distinguishing part of a camel's body would have to be the hump. And I guess that's why we get asked quite often whether camels store water in their hump or not.
In this brutally hot climate, we'd be lucky to last a day without water. But camels can go for 6 months without a single drop. That means they must be storing water somewhere. Marcus has devised a test to help shine a light on this camel conundrum.
Morning, Pixie.
He's enlisted the help of Pixie, a 22-year-old female. First, he needs to get her thirsty. One long walkabout in the outback later, and Pixie is ready for refreshments.
I can tuck away a lot of water.
Pixie can gulp down as much as 30 gallons of water in under 15 minutes. To find out if all that liquid is filling Pixie's hump, Marcus is going to use a thermal camera to scan her body. The camera will detect any specific areas where her body temperature has been made cooler by a giant drink of water. And this should stand out as blue on the thermal image.
He's had a big cold drink, and I don't see too much of a difference at all in his body imagery.
The hump has the same heat signature as the rest of Pixie's body. So where's all the water gone? Incredibly, almost all the 30 gallons she drank has been absorbed into her blood. When we drink water, it's absorbed into our blood and tissues. But if we drank as much water as Pixie, our blood would become so dilute, our blood cells would expand and burst. It's called water intoxication. And if the water enters our brain cells, swelling them, it can lead to seizures, coma, even death. So how is it possible for camel's blood to take on so much water? Unlike our round cells, camel blood cells are more flexible and oval-shaped. When the camel takes on water, these cells can expand to over 2.5 times their size without rupturing and still travel freely along the smallest blood vessels. It only takes 1.5 gallons of water to kill us, but a camel can suck down a bathtub full of water in one sitting. Once the water's in the blood, the camel's kidneys and gut work to preserve every last drop. So a camel's pee is like syrup, and its poop is so dry, you can burn it like wood. So if the hump isn't a water container, what is it? It turns out that deserts aren't only light on water, they're also light on food. That means camels have to go for weeks without eating to survive in the desert. So they stock up in times of plenty and store the food in the form of fat. Most mammals, including us, keep fat under their skin all around their body. Some have more than others. But it's not stored like our fat. If a camel had an insulating layer of fat all around its body, it could be dead by noon from heat exhaustion. Instead, they store fat in their hump. That way, the rest of the body can concentrate on keeping cool.